Let's show how easy it is for the citizen developer to build bots using no-code and low-code techniques. Anne, the citizen developer, is a subject matter expert who knows her process and wants to automate it. She logs into Enterprise A2019 on the web and views the bot that she has already begun. She needs to complete this bot whose purpose is to create new accounts in Salesforce.com. She spends several hours a day taking data from Excel spreadsheets and copying it into Salesforce, and she wants to automate this process so she can free up time to do other, more meaningful tasks. Upon logging in, Anne enters the bot workbench, where she can build and edit bots. Let's take a quick look at the bot. This bot has three different steps. First, there is a login module that consists of the recorder capture actions that automate entering the username and password. Both username and password credentials are stored in the credential vault and will be retrieved at runtime. The third action automates the login button. The next step is about taking the account information from the Excel spreadsheet and putting it into the Salesforce system and creating those new accounts. This is the section that she needs to complete. Anne needs to navigate to the accounts folder in Salesforce and begin creating new accounts with the data from the Excel sheet. Anne is a citizen developer. She doesn't know how to program a bot to insert data into Salesforce, so she launches the Universal Recorder to capture her actions. This is the no-code piece of the process. The Universal Recorder will automatically generate that portion of the bot for her. She selects the Salesforce.com window and proceeds to record her steps. The recorder will capture her mouse clicks and keystrokes on the application she selected, and then she will click on the fields that she wants to capture. She clicks the Accounts button. Note that the recorder highlights the fields to assist Anne, the citizen developer. She clicks the New button to get the new account window. She then proceeds to click on all the fields that will populate from the Excel sheet, such as the account name, the account type, the phone number, and the billing address. She can halt the recorder at any time, then resume it to continue her recording. She clicks the button to save the account and create a new account. When done, she ends her recording. She has quickly captured all the actions to create a new account. Anne can view her bot in multiple ways, and she switches to the list view to see the new recorded captures that were just added. The list view enables Anne to see the code of the bot line by line and provide enough detail so that she can quickly grasp what lines need to be updated to complete the bot. She will edit some of the actions to insert values from the Excel sheet. This action captured the account name. The object properties, including a visual preview, are shown on the right, and she can edit those properties. She can edit the keystroke field to simulate entering values from the Excel sheet. Simply put, she can now automate keystroke entries into this field. Here is the Excel. She will enter the first and last name into this field. The first name has an index value of 1, and the last name has an index value of 2, based on where they occur in the Excel sheet. She can perform similar steps for the actions that captured the phone number and billing address. Using the Universal Recorder this way enables citizen developers to quickly begin building bots. She has easily edited all the actions to retrieve values from the Excel sheet. She can now position these actions within the bot. She grabs the recorded actions and drags them into the correct modules within the bot. It is really easy for her to drag and drop code, and all the things that were recorded stay intact. She can click on each of the recorded actions and review the object details on the right. There are pre-built packages that Anne can pull from to enhance the functionality of her bot, and she can easily drag and drop these new actions into the bot. Now the bot is built, and she can switch back to the flow view, which shows her the complete process. Finally, she can view both flow and list views side by side, and saves the bot. Then she runs the bot. The control room connects to the device, deploys the bot to the device, and begins to run. The bot obtains the credentials from the credential vault and securely logs into Salesforce. Once there, it begins the account creation process and proceeds to the Accounts tab. It takes the data from the Excel file and starts to populate the fields. You can see here a series of new customer accounts being created in Salesforce based on the actions captured using the Universal Recorder. The bot creates these accounts at a much faster rate than if Anne had to copy and paste the data or enter it manually. One thing to note is the box on the lower right, which can be used to monitor the progress of the bot. This makes it very easy for citizen developers to understand what is happening within the automation process. The Universal Recorder enables citizen developers like Anne to easily create automations by simply recording their mouse clicks and keyboard activity. This makes it easy. No need to write code. It is a shallow learning curve that allows anybody to create bots. The bot runs successfully, and the new contacts have been created in Salesforce correctly. As a result, Automation Anywhere Enterprise A2019 helps transform subject matter experts into citizen developers through a web-based experience, no-code development with the Universal Recorder, and low-code development with a drag-and-drop design.